Hi, my name is Gretchen Carvajal. I'm a U Speaks alum. I'm now a poet mentor for the organization. And so I just feel real blessed to be in the building. My mother's side has diabetes. Diabetes is more and more a curse that we thought we brought to ourselves. We try to break it with a spell, a potion, and a ritual. What is insulin but a potion? What is a spell but a diagnosis? We take a tiny needle and prick our finger. What is a blood sacrifice to a blood test? I moved to America in 2001. This is like peak early 2000s, second grade, Halloween. Trick-or-treating was like a brand new experience for me, which was like, oh yeah, you're gonna go around and people are gonna give you free candy. And I was like, what? As a 7-year-old coming from a third world country and getting free candy, I was like, yo, I'm so down for America right now. Like, this is tight. Diabetes runs in my family through my mother's side. Her mother had it, her sister had it as well, and then my mother has it too. And now my older sister has it as well. So the Bigger Picture Project is a collaboration between U Speaks and Dr. Dean Schillinger, in which we do workshops based around health and food accessibility with our young folks, with poetry. So it sounds a little like disconnected, but it's really crazy how connected it is. Your relationship with health is also your relationship with your community. Your relationship with health is also your relationship with your family and with your body.
So try to jot down any like last minute stuff you're thinking of. For raise your hands in here, how many people in here know somebody with type 2 diabetes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 out of 8. That's like what, 90%+ of the room, right? That's wild.
How does this impact children and young people in a daily sense? Like, does it create other health issues? Does it like affect their lifespan? Like,
we've discovered that type 2 diabetes in a young person is more aggressive than in an older person. It's insidious and slow, progressive, so it's nasty stuff.
So gonna transition to like 10 minutes of writing.
So what do you reach for when you're hungry, and or what reaches for you?
Wow.
Yeah.
Anyways, like to share, bless us with some words.
Okay, you guys are staring at me. I want to be able to eat without second guessing, without thinking about a smaller version of myself, without thinking about food as a weapon or a setback. I want to be able to be hungry and eat without feeling like I'm killing myself. Mm-hmm. My body is a landmine of insecurities, my bloodline a generation of curses, a system that nobody has been able to break. When I'm hungry, I think about the bodies of women in my life and serving and eating last.
I really liked the line when you said food as a weapon. What did that mean to you?
Yeah, like all the intersections of my identity are like food as a weapon. As a Filipino and somebody from the East Bay who doesn't have that access, that's like a direct threat. But it's hard to grasp, like, what does that violence look like? And it's like, it looks like my whole family having diabetes and my mom having glaucoma because of her high blood sugar. And like, it looks like this and this and this, you know? But it's like for people who don't go through that and don't have, it's like, it's not even that bad. All you have to do is like, do those minuscule choices when it's like you literally don't have those choices sometimes. Filipino food is like so good, but it's also like, yeah, just a mix of a lot of like different struggles that we've been through. I think my family avoids talking about diabetes because they know it's a problem that they have to address. A cycle of not being concerned about your health, like I think that's a big cycle in my family. These things could be inevitable, but there are the things that are also preventable. When I think about like ending the cycle of diabetes, it's always gonna be my family.